subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreya Sabajay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. One of the youngest of the major religions and world's fifth largest organized religion, Sikhism originated in Punjab around the end of 15th century and is based on the teachings of its 10 gurus. One among these gurus also created the concept of Akal Takht, which serves as the supreme decision-making center of Sikhism and is located in Amritsar city of Punjab. Every year, the foundation day of Akal Takht is celebrated with immense enthusiasm by the Sikh community. This year too, a number of Sikhs gathered at the Golden Temple to commemorate the occasion. Take a look.
The sound of hymns and sacred songs resonated throughout the Amritsar city of Punjab as Sikhs marked the foundation day of their temporal body, Sri Akal Takht Sahib. Devotees gathered at the holiest shrine of Sikhism, the Golden Temple, to offer prayers and pay respect to the holy book, Guru Granth Sahib, to mark the auspicious occasion. Situated in the Golden Temple complex, the Akal Takht was established by the 6th Guru, Guru Hargobind, as a place where temporal issues of community members could be taken into consideration. When it was unveiled, Guru Hargobind put on two swords. One indicated his spiritual authority, known as Piri, and other his temporal authority, known as Miri.
Miri Piri de Malik, Sri Hargobind Sahib Maharaj Ji da sthapit kita hoya Sri Akal Takht Sahib di ajj sthapna divas diyan samuh sangatan nu ਬਹੁਤ ਬਹੁਤ ਵਧਾਈਆਂ।
Established in 1606, Akal Takht served as a symbol of political resistance against the Mughals during the 17th and 18th centuries. Akal Takht is also the first and the most important of the five takhts or seats of the religious power in Sikhism. It was adorned with gold by Hari Singh Nalwa, a basic of Maharaja Ranjit Singh. Every year, the foundation day of Akal Takht is observed with huge fervor by Sikh community across the globe.
Aaj Sri Akal Takht Sahib Ji da sthapna divas hai, is mahaan purv diyan samuche Guru Khalsa Panth nu Sikh sangatan nu bahut bahut badhaiyan. ਸ੍ਰੀ ਦਰਬਾਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਅੰਮ੍ਰਿਤਸਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਵੱਲੋਂ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਅਕਾਲ ਤਖਤ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਦੇ ਪੁਰਬ ਮਨਾਇਆ ਗਿਆ। ਸ੍ਰੀ ਅਖੰਡ ਪਾਠ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਦੀ ਸਮਾਪਤੀ ਉਪਰੰਤ ਅਲਾਹੀ ਬਾਣੀ ਦੇ ਕੀਰਤਨ ਹੋਏ ਨੇ।
ਟੁਡੇ ਅਕਾਲ ਤਖਤ ਆਲਸੋ ਸਰਵਸ ਐਜ਼ ਵਨ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਮੋਸਟ ਇੰਪੋਰਟੈਂਟ ਰਿਲੀਜੀਅਸ ਸਾਈਟਸ ਐਂਡ ਟੂਰਿਸਟ ਅਟਰੈਕਸ਼ਨਸ ਇਨ ਅੰਮ੍ਰਿਤਸਰ ਐਂਡ ਇਜ਼ ਵਿਜ਼ਿਟਡ ਬਾਈ ਲੈਕਸ ਆਫ ਟੂਰਿਸਟ ਐਵਰੀ ਈਅਰ।
In difficult times like these, it is important for all units of the society to join hands together and carve their way out in an adverse situation like coronavirus pandemic. Many such examples where people have actually implemented this have come to the limelight. The recent ones are from the Mumbai city of Maharashtra, where two individuals rising above religious lines have come forward to help the needy during this crisis.
Even amid these times of crisis, when the whole country is in the grip of deadly coronavirus, the picture of a unified and a secular India is still shining in full vigor. For the last couple of months, many NGOs, institutions, organizations and individuals have come forward to contribute their own bit to help the country tackle the problems that virus has caused. One such example is Mumbai's 17-year-old Zakir Hussain, who has spent all his savings to distribute PPE kits, sanitizers and food to all those who are in need. Zakir had collected around 15,000 rupees in a span of 1.5 years, which he spent on getting essentials for the needy. He decided to help those in need when he saw many people suffering due to the pandemic. Zakir then told his father to purchase PPE kits for the needy and gave up his savings in the blink of an eye. Gaining recognition for his good deeds and selfless service, Zakir was recently chosen as the president of Rotaract Club Mumbai, thus becoming the youngest president of the organization.
मैं सेव करते आ रहा हूँ पैसे देर साल से और फिर ये सिचुएशन देख के मुझे ऐसा लगा कि मुझे है ना सोसाइटी के लिए कुछ अच्छा करना चाहिए तो मैंने किया तो जब कोरोना वायरस जब शुरू हुआ था तब मुझे लगा था कि ये जो मिडिल जो वर्कर्स और वो सब है उनका क्या हाल होगा तो मैंने सोचा कि हम लोग कुक्ड फूड उनके घर तक पहुँचा सकते हैं और हमने वो किया और मैंने अपने जेब से वो पैसे खर्च किए थे और साथ साथ मेरे कुछ दोस्तों जो भी थे वो भी इन्वॉल्व हो गए थे।
Another example is Sion Friends Circle, who is coming forward to help the needy and the deprived amid the COVID-19 crisis. Based in Mumbai, this NGO has been distributing books, stationery items, and food to students of the slum area. With the motive to encourage children to continue with their studies despite schools being closed because of the pandemic. The members of Sion get dressed up as cartoon characters like Mickey Mouse, elephants and others while distributing the items among the children so as to put a smile on their faces.
हम लोगों ने ये खास आज ये प्रक्रिया शुरू की कि पिछले 70 से 80 दिनों में कोरोना का न्यूज़ देखते देखते कोरोना के बारे में सुनते सुनते बच्चे लगभग भयभीत हो चुके और बोर भी हो चुके तो साइन फ्रेंड सर्कल की ये मुहिम थी कि बच्चों को जिसमें इंटरेस्ट है ये डोरेमोन मिकी माउस खरगोश एलिफेंट जैसे चीज़ों जो हमारे सदस्य बनकर इनके बीच आए और इनके पढ़ने लिखने वाली चीज़ें उनको बांटा है
It is due to people and organizations like these that India is standing above the religious lines and is turning out to be united and rock solid in difficult situations like coronavirus outbreak.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Farmers in Uttar Pradesh are aiming the Middle Eastern markets to export their mango produce and increase their revenues. Indian mangoes, which account for 60% of the world's production, are in great demand and known as the king of fruits, but exporters are yet to tap the global market potential. India, being the largest producer of mangoes in the world, produces mangoes worth millions a year.
हमारे यहाँ का दशहरी है लंगड़ा है चौसा है और अदर्स वैराइटीज़ हैं अब उसको प्रमोट करने के लिए हमने काफ़ी मेहनत की है और सरकार ने भी हमारा साथ दिया तो हमने अपनी पूरी मार्केट में मिडिल ईस्ट की पकड़ की है पश्चिमी उत्तर प्रदेश के आम के लिए
Indian mangoes are exported to many Middle Eastern and European countries from India. They are used to make desserts, juice, shakes, mousse and puree.
India's national capital, New Delhi, recently started a serological survey on mass level as the number of coronavirus cases continued to surge in the city. The serological test comes as a part of new plan prepared by the federal government to battle COVID-19 in Delhi. The antibody test will determine the extent of the spread in the city. As infections mount swiftly and hospitals become stressed, some cities like New Delhi are scrambling to build temporary facilities and ramping up testing.
In a bid to boost its space sector, India will allow private players in major roles of space exploration more than just supply. Private industries will also be allowed research and development activities, and they can also be part of science and interplanetary missions of ISRO. The Government of India also approved the establishment of an autonomous nodal agency called the Indian National Space Promotion and Authorization Center in Space under the Department of Space as a separate vertical for taking independent decisions concerning permitting and regulating the private companies in the space sector.
We are very excited with the prospects of these reforms will bring and are confident that our innovative youth will come forward to avail all the opportunities arising from these reforms. Several startups have already come forward, and we are assured that India will emerge as a major hub for global space economy.
The agency will have its directorates for technical, legal safety and security, and activity promotion as well as for monitoring purposes. The private companies will also be allowed to build facilities within Department of Space premises. ISRO will also share technical expertise with the private players.
District Administration of Varanasi City in Uttar Pradesh resumed boat services in Ganges River after a shutdown of over 3 months. The central government had implemented the world's largest complete lockdown of 1.3 billion people for about 2 months to curb the rapid spread of coronavirus in the country. It had shut down all the services, including boats, and only essential services were allowed.
इतनी इसमें बहुत खुशी है भैया, बहुत गरीब तबके के लोग हैं नौका संचालन करने वाले, अगर जो रोज नौका चलाते हैं वही उनके घर चूल्हा जलता है। जब से नौका संचालन रुका हुआ है तब से आपको बता रहे कि समाज के प्रति में इतनी गरीबी है कि वो अपना जीविका नहीं चला पा रहे थे, और जैसे ही नौका संचालन की बात जैसे ही डीएम साहब ने आदेश दिया उसके बाद बहुत समाज के लोगों में बड़ी खुशी की लहर है।
बोट राइड्स ऑफ वाराणसी आर एन इंटीग्रल एलिमेंट ऑफ अ विजिट टू द हिंदू स्पिरिचुअल टाउन. They are popular for the views of sunrise and sunset through the majesty of holy Ganges River.
As both India and Pakistan face severe coronavirus crisis, the traditional beating the retreat ceremony continues in its full swing, albeit with empty spectator stands amid coronavirus concerns. Spectators were barred from witnessing the visual spectacle that happens every day for the last 60 years, after the management at the border on both sides said they couldn't ensure physical distancing with such huge crowds.
रिट्रीट समय तो सर जो रस्म है वो पहले की तरह चल रही है, उसी जोश के साथ चल रहा है, लेकिन यहाँ पर अभी पब्लिक का आना मतलब कोविड 19 के वजह से उनकी सुरक्षा को देखते हुए मतलब रोका गया है. और दूसरा यहाँ पर जैसे मास्क हो गया और सैनिटाइजर हो गया, उसका पूरा ही ध्यान रखा जा रहा है.
However, even without the spectators and the hyper-enthusiastic cheers, the tradition goes on. A cacophony of patriotic slogans and cheering is witnessed regularly when the ceremony is conducted every evening at Wagha in Amritsar district.
The world's famous Rath Yatra that takes place in Puri city of Odisha every year is followed by Bahuda Rath Yatra that takes place after 9 days. In this age-old tradition, the deities Lord Jagannath, Balbhadra and Goddess Subhadra return back in their chariots from Gundicha temple to their abode in the Puri temple. This return journey is not just a simple Hindu tradition, but also presents a wonderful example of communal harmony to the society when the chariot of Lord Jagannath stopped midway in the honour of a Muslim devotee. Take a look.
Just after covering a little distance during the Bahuda Rath Yatra, the chariot of Lord Jagannath, also known as Nandi Ghosh, stopped outside the grave of Solabega to pay homage to one of the greatest devotees of Lord Jagannath. Followed for the last 400 years, this tradition is a beautiful representation of the bond between a Hindu god and a Muslim devotee. One of the biggest poets of 17th century, Solabega was born to a Muslim father and a Brahmin mother. Though he lived in Vrindavan in Uttar Pradesh, but when he came to know about the Rath Yatra festival, he left for Puri with the desire to see Lord Jagannath. But in the way he fell sick, so he desperately prayed to Lord to wait for him until he reaches Puri. And it was due to the devotion of Solabega that even after being pulled by thousands of people, the chariot of Lord didn't move even an inch. It only moved when Solabega reached there and had the darshan of the Lord with his teary eyes.
If you go to past history, there is a Muslim man called as Bhakta Salabega. Bhakta Salabega was the powerful devotee of the Lord Jagannath. In the time of caste festival, Rath Yatra, the Bhakta Salabega stand a corner to look a darshan to Lord Jagannath, but he could not avail it. In the power of devotee and devotian, the lakhs of people pulling the rath, but rath was the stop. Due to power of the Bhakta Salabega devotian.
After this incident, Solabega stayed at Puri for rest of his life. During this time, he wrote a number of poems in the praise of Lord Jagannath. Even today, his poems and writings are an integral part of Jagannath tradition and resonate across the Puri city, especially during the annual Rath Yatra. This year, amid coronavirus outbreak, though the Supreme Court had earlier said that Rath Yatra cannot be allowed in the interest of public health and safety of citizens, it later on changed its decision after a number of people and organizations filed petition to the top court seeking a review of its decision. One among these petition was of a Muslim boy named Aftab Hussain from Odisha's Nayagarh district, who is now being called as the second Solabega for his noble move. A devotee of Lord Jagannath, Aftab believes
that it is all due to the grace of Lord that Rath Yatra is taking place.
18 तारीख सुनवाई हुई, 17 तारीख को मेरा फाइलिंग हुआ, लिस्टिंग हुआ, 18 तारीख सुनवाई हुई और मेरा खारिज हो गया। तो मैं 20 तारीख को रीपिटिशन व मॉडिफाइड पिटिशन किया था, तो उसकी सुनवाई में 22 तारीख को माननीय सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने अच्छी सुनवाई दिया। ये सब महाप्रभु जी का ही लीला है, मेरा इसमें कोई एक रोल नहीं है। तो ये सब हमारे उड़ीसावासी, हमारे भारतवासी, हमारे जगतवासी की प्रार्थना की ही खास बात है कि महाप्रभु उनके बात को सुन लिया।
India has innumerable number of such stories that can be found at every nook and corner of the country and also serve as a symbol of communal harmony that has kept people of various faiths bound together for ages. The Indian woodcraft has a big influence on the folk cultures and other art and crafts. Some states of the country hold a great deal of carving and woodwork that reflects the Indian craftsmanship. Moreover, there are a number of families in the country who have been involved in this woodcraft work for ages and are still carrying forward their ancestral legacy. One among them is the Jangir family based in Jaipur city of Rajasthan, who has been making the world's most exquisite sandalwood miniature carvings for generations.
Sandalwood is one of the most sacred herbs in Ayurveda. Native to Karnataka, the wood of this tree has been used since past many years for making effigies, sculptures, boxes, furniture and other things as well. Known for its aroma and medicinal qualities, objects made from sandalwood are famous all around the world and considered amongst the most expensive ones. Based in Jaipur city of Rajasthan, Jangir family has been creating sandalwood masterpieces with intricate carvings and careful detailing and are carrying the gift of craft gifted by their forefathers forward.
हम लोगों को ये काम करते हुए चौथी पीढ़ी होगी, तो मेरे दादाजी ने ये काम स्टार्ट किया था, श्री मालचंद जी जांगिड़। तो उन्होंने ये कब किया था ये तो मुझे याद नहीं है, लेकिन उनको नेशनल अवार्ड मिला था 1971 में, राष्ट्रपति थे बीबी गिरी, उनके द्वारा इस काम के लिए मिला था। और मेरे फादर को मिला था अवार्ड, नेशनल अवार्ड 73 में। मेरे को, मैं भी उनको देखते देखते ये काम सीख रहे हैं, हम लोग फैमिली काम होने की वजह से, तो मेरे को भी नेशनल अवार्ड मिला था 1993 में।
Carrying the ancestral legacy forward, Mahesh Jangir and his two sons Rohit and Mohit Jangir are creating statues and other sandalwood masterpieces with complex designs and intricate details. These masterpieces take around 10 days to 3 months for their completion, depending on the size of the sculpture as well as the details and layers that are to be done on the object. For example, it takes around 10 days to make an average size sandalwood clock to around 3 months to make a sandalwood sitar. Mahesh and his sons have received a number of national and international awards for their artistry and dedication to this forgotten art from just like their forefathers, and Rohit and Mohit have also dedicated their life to this art form and are starting to gain recognition for their artistry.
ये बचपन से करते आ रहे हैं तो काफ़ी ऐसे अच्छा लगता है, एक तो इंटरेस्ट भी बढ़ता जा रहा है इसमें काम में, कि जब से नया नया सीख रहे हैं और नया नया कर रहे हैं तो इसमें नई नई चीज़ें बना रहे हैं। तो पापा से भैया से इनसे सीखने को मिलता है कि नया चीज़ बनाने में ये आइटम ऐड हो सकता है, वो इसमें क्या नया कर सकते हैं, क्या हटा सकते हैं, तो इसमें एक नई चीज़ बनती है और अवार्ड वगैरह मिलते हैं, तो इससे काफ़ी उत्साह बढ़ता है और भी कुछ करने का इच्छा करते हैं इस काम के अंदर।
It is people like Mahesh and his sons who are carrying the ancestral legacy forward and are keeping the spirit of ancient Indian art forms alive from a number of years, along with preserving the essence of Indian culture and heritage.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@ANIN.com. This is Shreyasa Vijay and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.